Thank you, Sylvia. I've never spoken in front of many Mzungus as I am today. For those who don't know, Mzungu is a Swahili word for white person. So if I start stammering, you'll understand why. So my story is titled My Journey in Medicine. I'd like to start with the motivation behind me wanting to become a doctor. So when I was 8 years old, I got peptic ulcer disease. It's a disease in which you have erosion of your stomach or your intestines. So you end up presenting with symptoms like stomach pain, nausea, or vomiting. So I had these symptoms for a while, and it was not diagnosed that I had peptic ulcer disease because I had gone to a couple of public hospitals, and in Kenya, we don't have very developed equipment like you have here. So it took time before I was diagnosed. So my parents were finally referred to a pediatrician. It was a female doctor in Kenya at the time. There are not many female doctors. So she was very encouraging to my parents, telling me that this is something that normally happens and it's something that it can be healed. So from her, I derived a lot of motivation. I wanted to become a female doctor in a country where not many people have embraced education to female and profession like doctors in Kenya. So, I don't remember her name, but she was a good doctor that I remember. So anyway, she gave me good treatment and eventually I was healed after about 5 years. It took some time before I got better. And when I was 13 years old again, I got resistant malaria. You guys don't have a lot of malaria here. So for those who don't know about malaria, it's an infectious disease in Kenya, not in Kenya, mostly in Africa, caused by mosquitoes. So when it bites you, you get malaria. So if you have resistant malaria, you've been given drugs, but the drugs are not effective, so you continue having the symptoms for malaria. So you normally have headaches, fever, chills, those kinds of things. So I got resistant malaria, and the drugs that I was given were not effective. So I had to be given something else, and I was given quinine. I think you guys say quinine. Yeah, so I was given that after being admitted. So I was in the hospital for about a week. And after the quinine, I got better. So from the two illnesses that I had and from the doctor who treated me, being a lady in a country where not many people have embraced education, I decided that I wanted to venture into medicine. So I got into high school in 2009, and I went to a mixed high school in Kenya. Most of the high schools are single-sex high schools. So I went to a mixed high school. And if you're a girl in Kenya in a mixed high school, you need to work twice as much as the boys work, because they always have this notion that they are better than the girls, especially in math and sciences. So yeah, we used to wake up early, sleep late. Yeah, you do what you have to do, depending on the circumstance. So we worked really hard, and I thank God because I was able to get good grades and I was able to qualify for medical school. So I joined medical school in 2013, that's 5 years ago. First year of medical school is tough. Everyone here who has been to medical school can attest to that. So it's really tough, by the way. There's a lot of reading required, there's a lot of new vocabulary, there's a lot of time required, and you end up not having much of your social life as you do in school. But at some point, we got used to everything and we actually enjoyed life in medical school. So the journey was okay until 1.5 years ago. Some of you might have heard that we've had a couple of strikes in Kenya. I think the first speaker talked about the nurses' strike, which was there for about 4 months. So there were no patients for us to take care of. There have also been two doctor strikes, which lasted 4 months each. And there has been there have been two lecturer strikes also. So you can imagine all those strikes within a span of 1.5 years and all those strikes affecting you. So our academic calendar has been greatly affected and we are behind schedule. We were supposed to graduate next year, but currently we are still in fourth year. Normally Kenya has 6 years for medical school, unlike here. So we are still in fourth year and we normally come for the electives at the end of fifth year. So even coming here was an uncertainty for us, but we are happy that we've made it here. The people here have been so friendly to us. We've learned a lot from you guys, both in the hospital and socially. We don't have as much computers as you guys do here. We don't have as many cars as you guys here. Not many people work here, but in Kenya, it's the opposite. Socially, we've gotten to interact with many people in dinners and cookouts. We've learned new foods. Personally, I like nachos. Everyone has something they like. Yeah, and we've gotten to learn a few games like cornhole. And all in all, I'd like to appreciate the interaction between AMPATH, bringing Kenya and the US together. It's a good thing. And I'd like to end my story by saying asante sana. And my journey is now ending. I started as being a patient and wanting to take care of people. And now my journey is ending as me taking care of the people. So asante sana, that means thank you in Swahili.